Hello students, welcome back in the third video lecture based on chapter 10 haloalkanes and haloarenes. In this video we will discuss some other methods to prepare haloalkanes and haloarenes. Firstly, we will discuss the preparation of haloalkanes and haloarenes from hydrocarbons. We can prepare both haloalkane and haloarenes from hydrocarbons by the three ways. The first one is a free radical halogenation of alkane, the second one is a electrophilic addition of the alkene, and the third one is a electrophilic substitution of the arenes. In case of the free radical halogenation, the formation of alkyl bromide and alkyl chloride is possible. However, the radicals are in nature and highly reactive intermediates that results in the formation of the mixture of products. For instance, bromination or chlorination of free radicals in the formation of number of haloalkanes. This causes the difficulty in the isolation of the single product. For example, when methane react with the chlorine, it will give chloromethane plus HCl. When methane react with the chlorine in the presence of sunlight as an energy, the mixture of four products will be formed. Actually, all the hydrogen atoms of the methane are replaced and we get a mixture of various halogen derivatives. Like in this case, in the first case, the chlorine firstly that displaces this hydrogen and it will give us the chloromethane. And the second one case, if you get the chlorine in the excess, the second hydrogen is also replaced by the chlorine and we will get dichloromethane. And in the next case, the third hydrogen also replaced and we will get the trichloromethane. And the fourth step, we will get the tetrachloromethane. The reactivity order of the different halogens during the free radical halogenation is fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Actually, the fluorination is highly exothermic in nature. Fluoroalkane from this method. And chlorination, bromination and iodination, we can easily prepare chloroalkane, bromoalkane and the hydroalkanes. Mechanism of this reaction. Chemical mechanism has three steps. The first step is the initiation, the second is the propagation, and the third one is the termination. The initiation means the reactions will start at this step. In this step, firstly the free radicals are formed, like the halogen atom in the presence of sunlight get break down their bond and generate the halide radicals. The propagation means that in this step there is an increase in the length of the alkyne and the new radicals are formed in this case. Like halide radical formed in this step react with the alkane to give the alkyl radical plus the hydrogen that is replaced react with this halogen halide to give the HX that is a one of the R required product. And in this step the next new radical will form. And the third step is the termination. The termination means the complete products will form in this step. The termination, at the termination point, the new radicals are combined with each other to give the desired product and the mixture of the other products. Like if this X radical combined with this alkyl radical to give the one of the major product, if the X radical combined with the next X radical to give the halogen gap, and the next if the alkyl radical combined with the next alkyl radical, then there is a possibility to the formation of the higher alkanes also. Now, in case of the higher alkanes, the free radical halogenations become selective and we get the different kind of the isomers during the halogenation of higher alkanes. For example, in case of the bromination of the propane, we get 1-bromopropane and the 2-bromopropane in 3:1 directly attached to the one carbon only. Therefore, these carbons are the primary carbons and the hydrogen atoms attached to these primary carbon atoms are known as the primary hydrogen. And this carbon is the secondary carbon atom which is directly attached to the two carbon atoms and the hydrogen attached to the these secondary carbon atoms are known as the secondary hydrogen atoms. When the free radical halogenation is going on, there is a formation of secondary free radical here and primary free radicals will form on these cases. It means there are the more chances of the formation of the primary free radicals that the mixture of 1-bromopropane and the 2-bromopropane in the ratio of 3:1. It means 75% of 1-bromopropane will form and the 25% and 25% 2-bromopropane will form. But actually this case is totally different. The 3% of 1-bromopropane and the 97% of the 2-bromopropane. Can you answer this question? The answer of this question is the secondary free radicals are more stable as comparison to the primary free radicals. Here we will get 2-bromopropane as a major product and 1-bromopropane is the minor product. Basis of this, we will discuss the one NCERT textbook problem. In this problem, we have to identify all the possible monochloro structural isomers expected to form on the free radical chlorination of isopentane or 2-methylbutane. In this case, we have the four type of the hydrogen atom. It means the four isomeric monochlorides will form. These two carbon atoms are the A type, this is the B type carbon, this is the C type carbon and this is the D type carbon atom. This D hydrogen get replaced, the product will form 1-chloro-3-methylbutane. The C hydrogen will get displaced, the product formed is 2-chloro-3-methylbutane. And if the B hydrogen get displaced, the product formed is 2-chloro-2-methylbutane. And the A, if the both A hydrogens are displaced, the product formed is the 1-chloro-2-methylbutane. All of these are position isomers as the position of the functional group is changed in all cases. L, which is the major product in this case, as this carbon atom is directly attached to the three carbon atoms, this is the tertiary radical, this one is the secondary free radicals, and at A and D are the primary free radicals. Therefore, B formed the as a major formed, C is the second major product, and A and D will form the minor products. In case of the bromination, the bromine react with the alkene in the similar way, but this reaction is less vigorous as comparison to the chlorination due to the less reactivity of the bromine as comparison to the chlorine. For example, ethane react with the bromine in the presence of the sunlight to give ethyl bromide and the HBr. But the reaction of the iodine with the alkane is a reversible reaction due to the formation of the strong reducing agent hydrogen iodide. And due to the formation of this hydrogen iodide, this reaction become reversible and we will get the methane and the iodine back. Due factor of the hydrogen iodide, we will carry out this reaction in the presence of strong oxidizing agent like hydrogen iodic acid and the nitric acid. This hydrogen iodic acid and the nitric neutralize the hydrogen iodide to give iodine and the water molecules. The main advantages of this reaction is we need the iodine in the small quantity, and the rest of the iodine is formed during the chemical reaction. Now try these examples. We will discuss the allylic halogenation. In this case, we will prepare the allyl halides. During the allylic halogenation, the alkenes are treated with chlorine and the bromine at the high temperature of about 773 Kelvin. The hydrogen atom of the allyl carbon is substituted by the hydrogen atom, resulting in the formation of the, for example, when propane react with the chlorine at the temperature of 773 Kelvin, it will give us the allyl chloride. This is the allyl carbon, as it is next to the carbon-carbon double bond, and from this allyl carbon the hydrogen gets displaced to give us the allyl chloride. Similarly, an important reagent NBS is also used during the allylic halogenation, and this NBS is a N-bromosuccinamide. The structure of this reagent is this, and during the free radical mechanisms we will get the allyl bromide. This reaction is not possible at the lower temperature, as at the lower temperature chlorine or bromine atoms will attack directly on the double bonds, which we will discuss later on. And the next is the benzylic halogenation. In case of the benzylic halogenation, arenes having the benzylic hydrogen such as the toluene, ethyl benzene are treated with the halogen in the presence of sunlight. The halogenation takes place in the side chain of the benzylic halides. The main condition is again here the sunlight. This reaction is not possible in the dark, and in the presence of the dark, this CH3 group or the C2H5 group act as an electron releasing group. When this reaction is carried out in the presence of the sunlight, the hydrogen of the side chain get displaced to give us the benzylic halides. For example, when toluene react with the chlorine in the presence of the sunlight, it will give us the benzyl chloride. Similarly, in case of the ethyl benzene, when the bromine react with the ethyl benzene, the 1-bromo-1-phenylethane is formed. Formation of 1-bromo-1-phenylethane is the secondary free radical are more stable as comparison to the primary free radicals. We will discuss the reactivity of the different hydrogen attached to the different type of the carbon atoms during the free radical halogenation. We can explain the order of the halogenation in case of the benzylic and allylic on the basis of the resonance stabilization, as both benzyl and the allyl will participate in the resonance. In case of the allyl, there are the two resonance structures are possible, but in case of the benzyl, there are the three resonance structures are possible. Greater the resonance structures, greater will be the stability. Therefore, benzylic halogenation is the major product as comparison to the allylic halogenation. And the order of the tertiary, secondary and the primary carbon atoms can be explained on the hyperconjugation. Greater the hyperconjugations, greater will be the stability of the free radicals. Therefore, in case of the tertiary, secondary and primary, the order of the halogenation is a tertiary, secondary and the primary. And vinyl and aryl compounds are inactive during the free radical halogenation. Therefore, the correct order of the halogenation is benzylic compounds, allylic compounds, tertiary compounds, secondary compounds, primary compounds, vinyl and the aryl. Now, during the preparation of alkyl halides from alkene, the alkenes can be converted into haloalkanes by the electrophilic addition reaction. The alkenes then assist to form the alkyl halides. High electron of the double bond has greater electron density. It promotes the electrophilic addition reactions. In electrophilic addition reactions, the electrophile or the electro-loving substrate attack on the pi electron, the alkene, give the electrophilic addition reactions. Here, H positive act as a electrophile, and this pi electron, and due to the greater electron density of this pi electron, this H positive ions will attack on the pi electrons of this alkene. When this H positive ions get attacked on the pi electron of this carbon, there is a generation of the carbocation. In the next step, there is a nucleophilic attack of the Br negative ions. This Br negative ions get attached to this carbocation to give the respective alkyl halides. The symmetrical alkenes, the only single products will form, as the symmetrical alkenes are the those alkenes where the number of carbon atoms on the both side of the double bonds are equal. But in case of the unsymmetrical alkenes, this is of the formation of different kind of the product on the basis of the stability of the carbocation and the free radicals. In this case, there are the two conditions when the reaction is proceed in the presence of the peroxide, or if the reaction is proceed in the absence of the peroxide. If reaction is proceed in the absence of the peroxide, it will follow the Markovnikov's rule, and the 2-bromopropane is formed as a major product. If this reaction is proceed in the form of the peroxide, it will follow the anti-Markovnikov's rule, and 1-bromopropane is formed as a major product. And the same thing we already discussed in the class plus 1. Things react with the dihalogen with the alkene, it gives you the vicinal dihalides. Example, the addition of the bromine water to an alkene resulting in the discharge of the reddish brown color of the bromine due to the formation of vicinal dibromide. We are colorless without at the lower temperature, as at the higher temperature it will follow the allylic halogenation, allylic halogenations as discussed previously. The next method is the electrophilic substitutions. In this method, we will prepare aryl halides. In this process, the highly active electrophile displaces the less active, the poor electrophile. By this process, we can prepare aryl bromide and the aryl chloride by the using of the halogens such as the chlorine and the bromine in the presence of loose acids such as the iron chloride, iron bromide and the aluminium chloride. This reaction can be carried out in the absence of the, and the catalyst used in this reaction act as the halogen carrier. The loose acids are the those acids which can easily attract the lone pair of the electron towards itself. For example, the benzene can be converted into the bromobenzene in the addition of the bromine and the iron bromide. Similarly, the chlorobenzene can be prepared by the addition of the chlorine with benzene in the presence of iron chloride. The mechanism of this reaction has 3 steps. In the first step, the generation of the electrophile. The second step is the formation of the carbocation, and the third step is the abstraction of the proton from the carbocation. In the first step, the electrophile will generate by the loose acid. This loose acid, iron chloride, abstract the electron from the chlorine and generate the electrophile Cl positive. This Cl positive in the second step will help in the formation of the carbocation. As the pi electrons are moving from one position to the second position, for example, when this pi electron move towards this carbon, this Cl positive ions attack to this carbon, because at this point, when the electron density become higher, this Cl positive ions attack on this carbon atom and resulting in the formation of the carbocation. And due to this, the carbocation will form at this point. The carbocation generated at this point get stabilized by the resonance. In the third step, there is an abstraction of the proton from the carbocation. This abstraction of the proton can be done by the FCl4 positive, which is generated in the first step, and it will give the chlorobenzene along with the side product iron chloride, which is our catalyst, and HCl. As both X negative and CH3 negative are acting, and if we add halogen in the excess amount, the second halogen will get introduced at the point of the ortho and the para position. Similarly, in case of the toluene is also ortho para directing, the next halogen atom will attack on the ortho and the para position, and it will give the ortho chlorotoluene, and the second product is the para chlorotoluene. And the higher activity of the toluene towards the halogenation can be explained on the basis of the plus I effect. Preparation of the haloalkanes and the haloarenes by the halogen exchange method. In this method, we will discuss the two naming reactions, Finkelstein reaction and the Swart reaction. In case of the Finkelstein reactions, idoalkanes are easily prepared from the chloroalkanes and the bromoalkanes by the treating it with the solution of the sodium iodide. When the chloroethane is treated with the sodium iodide in the presence of acetone, it will give us the idoethane. This reaction is known as a Finkelstein reaction. We use sodium iodide in this reaction as it is highly soluble in the acetone, while sodium bromide and the sodium chlorides are not soluble in acetone. In case of the Swart reaction, we can prepare the fluoroalkanes, and this is the only method by which we can easily prepare the fluoroalkanes. In this reaction, the alkyl fluoride are best prepared by the halogen exchange. In this reaction, the alkyl bromide or the alkyl chloride are treated with mercuric fluoride, cobalt fluoride and the antimony fluoride to give the respective fluoroalkane. Methods to prepare haloalkanes and the haloarenes are: first is the Borodine-Hardaker reaction. In this reaction, bromoalkanes are easily prepared by the refluxing a mixture of silver salt of the fatty acids. Fatty acids are the RC double bond O carboxylate, means the carboxylate ions are known as the fatty acids. The acids of the silver are treated with the bromine in the presence of carbon tetrachloride to give alkyl bromide carbon, and along with the silver bromide and the carbon dioxide. But we cannot prepare idoalkane by this process, as iodine react with the silver salt of the fatty acid form esters. What happen in this case, when the silver acetate or the fatty acids of the silver treated with the iodine in the presence of carbon tetrachloride by the process of the refluxing, it will converted into the methyl acetate along with the carbon dioxide and the silver iodide. Now try these examples. The next is the preparation of the haloarenes from the disonium salt. Again, in this process, we will discuss the two naming reactions, the Sandmeyer reaction and the Gaterman reaction. In case of the Sandmeyer reaction, the disonium salt are treated with the salt of the copper to give the chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, cyanobenzene and cyanobenzene. And similarly, if you take copper instead of the copper salt, this reaction is called as a Gaterman reaction. And in this reaction, the disonium salt react with the copper to give the chlorobenzene along with the nitrogen gas. Next, we can prepare fluorobenzene from the diazonium salt, and this reaction is known as the Blaas-Simon reaction. What happened in this case, the diazonium salt treated with the fluoroboric acid, firstly it will give the intermediate N2+ BFR negative. When you heat this intermediate at the higher temperature, it will give you the fluorobenzene, nitrogen and the BF3, that is a boron trifluoride. And this reaction is known as a Blaas-Simon reaction, and this is the best method to prepare the fluorobenzene from the diazonium salt. This is all about the methods of preparation of the haloalkanes and haloarenes. Try to read this topic from your NCERT book along with your some extra book for the better clarification.